today at New Salem Elementary School.
This is Grant Howard and Madeline Calderon reporting to you from our WNSC studio.
Today is Monday, August 26, Cycle 1, Day 4. Mrs. Green is here for art and Ms. Cole is here for music.
For lunch today, the regular is a shrimp poppers with a whole grain roll.
There isn't any alternate choice today, but there is a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Happy birthday wishes go to Maurice Roebuck and Wyatt Rogers, who celebrated their birthday over the weekend. Additional birthday wishes go out to Gabriella Briner today.
Happy birthday!
Today's forecast calls for the temperatures in the low 80s with partly sunny skies.
This morning, third and fourth grade students will get the chance to try out string and band instruments that they might be interested in playing during the school year.
Did you know that on this day in 1920, the 19th Amendment giving the woman the right to vote went into effect?
Check this out.
It's time to have a little fun with learning, and today I am talking about the 19th Amendment for kids. Before I talk about the 19th Amendment, I have to talk about how the United States of America has the Constitution. The Constitution gave individual states an organized set of laws that outlined the powers given to the federal government. The 19th Amendment is a part of the Constitution that says, "The right of citizens of the United States to vote shall not be denied or abridged by the United States or by any state on account of sex." Prior to the 19th Amendment, there were still states where women were not given the same rights as men in the country to vote in elections. Many women began fighting for equal rights in the 1800s. Women who were a big part of what was called the women's suffrage movement included Elizabeth Cady Stanton, Susan B. Anthony, Sojourner Truth, and more. When a bill is introduced in Congress, it does take time to become a law. The 19th Amendment did not make its way into the Constitution very easily. It was first introduced by Aaron A. Sargent of California in 1878. It took years before it was voted on and was rejected. This went on for years, failing to make its way to being a law until finally President Woodrow Wilson got involved and the 19th Amendment was passed by Congress June 4th, 1919 and ratified on August 18th, 1920. The 19th Amendment granted women the right to vote. After a long fight, by November 1920, women were allowed to vote, and I hope you enjoyed learning about the 19th Amendment for Kids.
Thank you for watching our broadcast today at New Salem Elementary School.
Are you ready to launch?
I'm ready to launch.
It's go time, New Salem!
Please rise for a moment of silence, followed by the playing of our national anthem and the pledge to the flag.